that's all with the user defined constructor. Now coming next, we have purpose of the constructor. Now in lesson 03, when we are learning on the method, we have you knew that the purpose of the method is to write the logics of the application. Okay, now similar to that, till now we have been just using those constructor, and we never know what are the purpose of the constructor, why we are using constructor in Java. If there is no purpose in purpose of constructor, then it's no use of using this constructor. So therefore, let's look at the purpose of the constructor in Java, similar to that of the method. Now the purpose number one is to write the business logics and business logics at object creation. So I'm going to show this purpose number one, to write the business logics at object creation, with the help of example. Okay, so constructor similar to that of the method. So here we have the method and we have the constructor. So similar to that of the method, constructors are also used to write the business logics. So here I've highlighted purpose of the constructor. The number one is to write the business logics at object creation. Okay. Now how we are writing the business logic at object creation? So let's try to look with the example. Let's just try to remove this and it will give error. Now, purpose of the constructor. Purpose of the constructor, number one is to write the business logics. Now this example is similar, this example will be okay to understand the purpose of the constructor. So this is how we are using constructor in writing the business logics. Okay, so here I just wanted to write something here. So at this point, we are at this point, business logic will be present. Okay, similar to this, here also business logics will be present. Now, when you will use this constructor to write the business logic is that at the time of developing an application. So when you are developing the application, you will get a requirement like you just wanted to execute something at the time of object creation. So here we have seen it. You will be required and you will need a requirement that you have to write some logics to be executed during the object creation. That time, you will have to use the constructor to execute your business logic at the time of object creation. So only then other statements will be executed. So if you require an requirement that you want to execute something during the object creation, you will be always doing with the help of constructor. Now this purpose is used only 25%. So other 75 percentage it will be with a different purpose. So we are just going to show you. So this is how we are using the constructor, the purpose of the constructor for writing the business logics. Okay. Now let's look at the next slide here. Now, purpose of the constructor number two. So here, sorry. Now, the purpose of the constructor number two is constructors are used to initialize some values to the instance variables during object creation. So this purpose is used 75% in the project development, in the real-time project development. So you have to understand this clearly. So constructor is used to initialize some values to the instance variable during the object creation. So now how we are using, how it is initializing those values to the instance variable during object creation, we want to do it with the practical and understand it, okay? So let's try to do it here. Purpose two. To initialize the instance variables during the object. The purpose number two is to initialize the instance variables during the object creation. This during object creation is important, okay? So you have to know. So initializing of the instance variables during the object creation. Now how we are initializing during the object creation, let's just look at the example. Let's just try to remove this code. It's not required now. Let's say, let's not use class test. Let's use class EMP. So it shows some meaning for the example. So let's say we have a class EMP, and let's try to declare some instance variables here. Instance variable. Let's say we have int EID, the employee ID. Then let's say string E. String e name, employee name. Then let's say we have float e salary. Okay. Now let's try to declare one method. Now this example is to make you understand how to initialize the instance variable during the object creation. The purpose number two. So this is very important in project level. You have to understand this purpose too, to initialize the instance variables during the object creation. Okay. So let's, we are declaring three instance variables here. We are declaring int EID, then string e employee name, then employee salary. Okay. Now let's try to declare one method to display the employee ID, employee name, and employee salary. Okay, let's say we have void DISP. Let's declare one. This is the method to display. So let's say this is the logic of the application. Let's try to print the employee ID, employee name, and employee salary here. Let's say we have employee ID, EID. Then let's just copy this. let's just change this name. Salary, employee salary, then let's just try to print salary here. So this is the method declaration. We are just declaring one display method to just print out the values of this employee ID, employee name, and the employee salary. Okay, now we have done the declaring the instance, three instance variable, then we have declared one method here. So till here, I hope you've understood what I'm trying to do. Now let's try to call this method DISP here. So this is the instance variable. We are trying to access to the static area. So always we have to do it with the help of object. So this concept you will use in the project development, and you should know this concept. New test. Now let's try to call this method. So here we have created one object, and we are trying to call the display method. Now just predict what will be the output. So just predict in your mind that that will be the output. So I hope you have predicted what will be the output. So let's try to execute. Let's just save this. Now we have EMP class, so we have saved the file as test.java. Let's just try to. We have to compile with the class name, okay? Class name, I mean, file name. You have saved it as test.java. So we have some error here. Please remove or make sure it appears in the correct. Let me check it here. EMP. Zero says. Duplicate class EMP. Oh. I think we have a duplicate class EMP, so I just wanted to remove that. Java training practical. Let's save it. So let's try to execute again. Compile again. I've made mistake here. I have to, because we have a class EMP, we have to do it with a class EMP. Save it. Sorry for the mistake. Let's compile. We have saved the Java file as test.java. Let's compile successfully. Now let's try to execute. We have given the class name as EMP. So how to give the naming condition and all, I have already covered in the lesson one. I don't have to repeat this. So if your class is declared as EMP, you have to execute as Java EMP, okay? Now, so just cross-check with your thinking of the answer. So earlier, now here we didn't initialize any values for these three instance variables. And because we have not initialized the value, that's why it is printing the default values. So the JVM is providing the default values for these variables, int EID, EID enum and salary. So we have int EID, the default value for int is zero. So if the default value for the string is null, then default value for the float data type is 0.0. Okay, so that's why here it is giving the default values. So why we are now, so this is the problem. This is the problem. There is some issue with this code. So default values are not required. So it shouldn't be printed. So in the project development or all, you have to give the valid or print the or output the valid data. So therefore, how to overcome this default value initialized by the JVM is with the help of constructor. So let's use constructor to initialize the values. I mean, initialize the instance variables during the object creation. So at this point, we are using the constructor. So if you are not using, actually the constructor is here, but we are using the default constructor. The default constructor will be here. Default constructor will be here. EMP with a empty, with the empty implementation with a zero. So if you're not declaring at least one constructor, then compiler will be generating the default constructor at this point within the class. So this is how, as soon as the object is being created, so this default constructor will be called, then this display method will be called. Okay, so this is just default, so it's not required. It will be called automatically with at the back end. Okay, as soon as this object is created, then this void display method will be called and this default value will be printed. So these values are the instance variables. The instance variables are S is all over within the class. Okay, that's why we are printing the default values here. Now we have a problem here, that is we have printed the default values for these instance variables. Now let's try to overcome this problem. Now to overcome this problem, let's try to use one constructor, declare one constructor here. Let's say we have EMP class name and the constructor name must be same. Let's try to initialize this instance variables. Let's say EID equal to let's say 2833, then ename equal to let's say it's slim, then e salary is equal to let's say 20,000.5. Yes, we have to give the f because default value for decimal point is double. So it is mandatory that we have, if you are declaring the data type as float, then it is mandatory that we have to use the constant f. Okay, now we have initialized, we have declared, this is the user defined constructor. Okay, this is not the default constructor because we don't have an empty implementation, we have a logics here. This is we have a few statements here. So for a default constructor, this should be the empty implementation and it should be zero argumented. This is zero argumented, but we have the logics here. So this is the user defined constructor with zero argument. Okay, you have to understand every bit of this zero argument. So because we don't have a constructor here, I mean, we don't have a parameter here. That's why it's a zero argumented constructor. So this part is the constructor, and what we have used this constructor is here, purpose number two, to initialize the instance variables during the object creation. So here exactly, we are initializing the values to these instance variables. Okay, to initialize the instance variables during object creation. This during object creation is important because at the time of object creation, so as soon as this object is being created, this constructor part will be called, and as soon as this object is called, then those instance variables will be initialized during the time of object creation. So you have to understand, you have to remember this. So to initialize the instance variables during object creation, initialization of the instance variables take place during the object creation. Okay. So this is the purpose two. So let's try to save this. We have an EMP, we have an EMP. Just checking. Save this. After editing, we have to save and we have to compile it again. test.java, okay. Compile successfully. Now let's try to execute this program. Java, we have class name EMP. So here, partially we have solved the problem. So earlier, when we are not using the constructor, the default value is being printed. Now here, when we are using the constructor, we are given with the exact values, that is employee EID is equal to 33, then ename is equal to selling, then eSalary is equal to 20,000.5. Okay, now let's try to let's say for here, for this example, we are using only one object. Now let's say we have two objects, that is two employees. Let's try to create another object, EMPT2. EMPT2 is equal to new EMP. So this is the second object, and we are trying to call this object. We are trying to call this method, I mean method, not object. let's just keep it as E, not T. So it's giving a valid meaning. Let's say this employee one and employee two, okay? Let's say employee two dot TISP. Here we are not using T, it will give error. Let's see E1. So employee one, display employee one details. It means display employee one details, then display employee two details. So let's try to execute this program. Let's try to save it. We have to save it after editing. Now let's try to compile this. Let's do clear. This is the comment to compile the Java program. Compile successfully. Now let's try to execute. We have class name as EMP. Now here, details of the employee, two employees has been output printed here. This is the details for the first employee, and this is for the second employee. But we have seen here that there is some problem with this output, because we have two employees, the separate two employees. So for a different employee, the details should be different. But here, what we have seen is that for the two employees, the details, the EID, the name, and the salary is same. So therefore, to overcome this problem, we have to use the parameterized constructor. Okay, so here we have used the zero argumented constructor. So when we are using only one employee, it's giving the right output. But whereas when we are creating multiple objects, when we are creating two employees, then it is printing the same value. So therefore, in order to overcome that problem, we have to use a parameterized constructor. Okay, parameterized constructor. I just wanted to edit this code here. Let's see. Let's just remove this. This is giving problem. This is a user-defined constructor. This is a user-defined constructor. Let's solve this problem, printing of the same details for the two employees. So you want to solve it with the help of using the parameterized constructor. Okay. Now let's say we have a constructor EMP, class name, and the constructor name must be same. It is mandatory. It's a rule for the constructor in Java. So let's say we have a parameter. Let's provide these three parameters, the instance variables. Int EID, then string E name, then float E salary. Okay. This is a user-defined constructor with three argumented constructor. So this is the constructor. So we have three parameters here. So int EID, string ename, float E salary. Okay. Now this is a parameterized constructor with three argumented constructor. This is a user-defined constructor with three argument. Okay, three parameters. Now these are the local variables. So in the variables concept, so the reason I am focusing on to understand those concept about variable and method and all, so is because in every Java projects, you have to deal with these variables and all, every concept for Java, like constructor, instance block, static block. When you are learning every bit of these Java concepts, you have to know the variables concept. So here we have three variables, EID, ename, and eSalary. And we have a data type, this is int, string, and float. Now, when you are declaring a variable or a parameter inside the constructor or method, now these variables are the local variables, okay? Always remember this. These are the local variables, and these variables, EID, then ename, and eSalary is accessible only within this constructor, only within this constructor. It is not accessible to other methods and inside the class. So it is local and it is accessible only within this constructor. Similar to that, if you are declaring some parameters in this display, this method, then those variables will be accessible only within this class. It will not accessible to this constructor or inside the class. So therefore, we are declaring three parameters here. So these parameters are local variables, okay? And it will be accessible only within this constructor. So therefore, here, what we are trying to do is, we are just trying to, before this, I just wanted to do this here. Let's try to call this display method inside the main method, because execution of the program starts from the main method by the JVM, okay? Now we have test. No, no, I'm just writing test. So we have EMP clause here. And let's say we have employee one is equal to new EMP. Now we are trying to here. We are trying to call this constructor EMP with three parameters. Now I have told you that at the time of constructor calling, this part is the constructor calling, and at the time of constructor calling, we have to pass the values to the constructor. So we have three parameters here: in EID, ename, and eSalary. So we have to pass values. Now we have employee ID. Let's say 2845. Then we have ename. Let's say employee Trashy, and let's say a monthly salary of 20,000.5F. And this is how we are passing the values to these parameters. We have three parameters here. So we are here, we are passing values to those, values to this constructor. Okay, this is how we are doing. We are passing the values to the constructor. At the time of the object creation, this constructor will be executed. Okay, now let's say we have created one object E1. So let's try to call E1 this method with this object TISP. Now if we try to execute this program, so it will not give an error, but it will print the default values. Why? Because actually we are passing the values here, but we are passing the values to these local variables. And so at the time of object creation, those parameters will be initialized with the values. That is 2845 Trashy and 20,000.5 will be assigned to these variables, but this will be the scope of this. This is a local variable, and the scope will be only within this constructor, and it will not be accessible to this method. So in order to make these local variables scope global or to access within the class, we have to convert these local variables to the instance variables, because instance variable is accessible anywhere within the class. So how we can do this is with the help of we have to use conversion, that is with the help of this keyword. Okay, so how we are using is we just have to let's say this is the conversion of local variables to instance variables. Okay, now how we are converting this local to the instance variable is with the help of using this keyword. So this keyword is very important in Java. Okay, so you have to know. So let's say this dot, we have EID is equal to EID. So this is how we are converting. Now this part is the instance variable, and this is the local variable. So this is how we are converting those, this local to the instance. Similar to this, we have to do same. This dot e name is equal to e name, and salary this dot e cell is equal to e. This is how we are converting. This is the right part. So this EID, ename, and eSalary is representing the local variable, whereas d.eid, d.ename, and d.eSalary is representing the instance variable. So this is how we are converting these local variables to the instance variable. Now, after doing this, what will happen is, now, as soon as the object is being created here and values being passed, these values will be assigned to these local variables, the EID, ename, and eSalary. Then, after that, then the conversion will be taking place because we are creating the object here, and constructor will be executed during the object creation. You have to remember during object creation, always remember during object creation, this constructor part will be executed. During the object creation, this value, this constructor will be called, then it will be, the constructor part will be executed. It will, now what happened, the values which we have provided here will be assigned to this constructor, EID, ename, and eSalary. Then after that, the initialization of the conversion will be taking place. So these local variables will be assigned to these instance variables. Now let's check the output. Let's just save this. We have test file, test.java. Compile successfully. Now let's try to compile, I mean execute. JVM is always responsible for execution of the program. Compiler is for compiling of your code, conversion of your dot class Java into dot class, whereas JVM main responsible is loading the dot class file into the memory and calling the main method for the execution. Okay, now at this time JVM will be during the task. Java, we have class emp, Java emp. Now here we can see the details is being printed. Now let's say this is for only one employee, one object. Now let's create another object. Let's say we have second employee, that is E2 is equal to new EMP. Now we are using the same constructor, this constructor. So for that, we have three parameters here. We have to pass three values, 28, 23. Let's say this is the employee ID. And let's say his name is Ogen. Now let's say he has a monthly salary of 45,000. Actually, she don't get 45,000. It's just sample program. Let's say we have an employee E2, EMP, his employee ID is 2833, name is Ugen, then he has a monthly salary of 45,000, okay? Now this is the employee. Now similar to the execution of this will be also getting executed. So let's try to call this display method for this E2, employee 2. Now, to understand this program, you have to also know the earlier programs. And so because we in the earlier programs, there is a error, like when we are not using the constructor and the default value is being printed, but even when we are using constructor without the parameter, the purpose is being served for one employee, but when we create multiple objects, multiple employee objects, then the problem arises in printing of the same details for the different employees. So therefore, so by using this parameterized constructor, so those problems have to be solved, okay? Now this is how we are doing. So we are creating second employee object. So since we are using this constructor, we have three parameters, we are passing the three values similar to that of a method. So if you understand method, you will understand this easily. So let's try to, now this part will be always remember that executed during the object creation. So similarly, this will be also exe cd executed during the now you have to remember is this part is executed, the constructor part, this is the constructor, and this part is executed during the object creation. During the object creation is important, okay? So now let's try to execute this. We have done, I will talk on the flow of execution after this output. Let's try to save this. After editing, we always have to save the program. Let's compile. This is how we compile the program. Now it's compiled successfully without any error. Now let's try to execute. JVMS responsible for this. Responsible for execution, JVK Java. We have a class EMP. Okay, now test, because we have already declared the class as test, but we have saved the file as test.java. So if you have declared the class as different file name, then you have to give the class name at the time of execution. So we have EMP class here. We have EMP class, okay? Here, this is the EMP. So that's why I'm using EMP at the time of execution. So Java EMP. Now, see here, for different employees, we have two employees. For different employees, different detail is being printed. So this is how we are using the constructor in the projects, okay? The actual purpose of the constructor that we have gone through two purposes of the constructor. One is writing the logics. Constructors can be also used to write the logics of your application, but writing logics inside the class is rarely used. It is used around 25% as per I know from the internet and all. This constructor is used in the initialization of the instance variables during the object creation. So 75% of the programmers use these constructors for the initialization of the instance variables during the object creation. Okay. Now let's try to create another object. Let's say we have EMP E3. Let's say we have Sonam, and you have a salary of 50. Let's try to call this method for this E3 dot let's try to execute. Compile successfully. Now here, so finally we have solved all the problems. So the first problem was default values being printed. The second problem was for different employees, same details is being printed. But now, after using the parameterized constructor for initialization, we have solved all these problems. Here we have employee E1 with the details, then we have employee T2 with the different details from the E1, then we have employee E3 with the details different from other two employees. So that's the actual purpose the real purpose of the constructors in Java. Now, I hope you have understood where actually is this constructor part is executing, when this constructor part execution happens and all. Now for you, just for a recap, I just wanted to show the flow execution of this. As soon as the JVM calls the main method, this object creation will be taking place here. This is object creation, the first statement. This object creation will be taking place now. As soon as this object creation is at the time of object creation, this is a constructor part. Now this constructor will be called. So now the program, this will look for a constructor in this class now. So here we have a constructor. As soon as the object is being created, then it will look for this constructor. Then this constructor part will be executed. The values will be assigned to these parameters here. We have three parameters. These values will be being assigned to these parameters. Then conversion will be taking place here inside the constructor. Then only after complete creating this object, then only so this e1.display will be called, and this EID ename eSalary will be printed. This is printing the valid values because we have converted these local variables to the instance variables here. We have converted to this instance variable because of that. So this instance variable's scope is anywhere. It can be accessed anywhere within the class. So that's why we are able to print the valid details. So this is how it is happening. Same for this employee E2 and E3. So I hope you have understood with this. So just one information here. Now I have used this here, right? So now this, we have to use this only if you are declaring same variable names here. So we have same variable names for local and the instance. This is the instance variable, EID, ename, and eSalary, and this is the local variable. Now we have to do the conversion if you are giving the same name for this local variable and the instance variable. Now if you are using different name, like let's say you are using employee ID as let's say EMPID, then let's give the string name is EMP name, then let's say salary float salary is EMP salary. Now if you are declaring different name, then for this you don't have to use this. For the conversion, you can just remove this and you can just use EMPID, then just remove this and just use EMP name, just use this, remove this and just say EMP salary. This will work perfectly. Okay, now let's try to execute this. Now let's try to save this and let's try to execute. Okay, we have class name test, we have file name test.java. It's giving error because we have changed the name here, so it should be EMP ID, EMP name, EMP salary. Okay, save it. So the you have to also read this those error message. Let's try to compile this program. Compile successfully without any error. Now let's try to execute Java. We have class EMP. So that's all with this purpose of the constructor, okay? Now this is very important, and you have to know the concept of this, how and where it is executing and all. Now, I just wanted to give you one information, one last information regarding this constructor. So after that, I'm going to look at one concept, that is constructor calling. Before that, let's just remove this. So I hope you have understood this, the purpose of the constructor. The first purpose is mainly for writing the logics of the application. So if you require in the project, if you require any requirement, you want to execute or execute some business logic at the time of object creation, you have to use the constructor, okay? Now, writing of the logics within the constructor, it is rarely used. Mostly this constructor is mainly used in the initialization of the instance variables during the object creation. So during the object creation is important, okay? Now that's all with the purpose of the constructor.